Hi, I'm Gina. Welcome to my channel. I'm going to do flip through of one of my new books. It's got a lot of photos, a lot of really beautiful photos, so I'm going to take my time over this book. And I'm going to play one of my new CDs. Just a sec. Because I played it the other day and it was just beautiful, so I'm going to give you the benefit. Just a beautiful, beautiful CD, Elvis Romantic, the Romantic. I've got a few CDs about Elvis the Romantic, but this has got a few different songs from the other ones. I'm sorry if I sound like I've got my mouth full. I have, actually. Been eating some lunch. Here we go with Elvis. And Faces and Spaces and Stages.
If you find your sweetheart in the arms of a friend, that's when your heart begins. When dreams of a lifetime when your heart is begin.
Sorry, I'm just trying to get the focusing right.
If you find your sweetheart,
I haven't read this book yet, but the photos are
in the
fantastic.
Arms of your best friend. Brother, that's when your heart aches.
Yes, I've seen some before, but a lot I haven't.
And you know, when all your dreams, when all your dreams of a lifetime must all come to an end. Yeah, that's when your
Tom Biskin, waking Elvis up.
Well, you see, love is a thing that you never can share. And you know, when you bring a friend, into your love affair,
that's the beginning
of your sweetheart, that's the end of your friend.
When your heart is begin.
Sometimes when long honeymooners at night.
Somehow this CD just seems to suit this book, seeing the nearly early photos.
Far above par.
Oh, and people said back then in the 50s they thought he couldn't
what
sing.
Good.
Yes.
And you give.
I love this song.
To me.
Man.
True love.
So I'll go through some others. This one might take a bit longer. Another beautiful bit. Elvis In Concert, John Reggero.
I will be home again. Don't worry, dear. I'll be home again. So won't you try the tea?
I'm expecting some friends over for dinner soon. I can see where they're going to come up the front or the back path, so I might just have to drop the camera and run there, right? See how we go.
There'll be brighter skies when I come back to you.
Fans of scars.
Darling, until then, our dreams will happen. Ah, sweetheart, the love you're giving thrills my hungry heart.
Photos are buried in the centerfolds. Outfits. These are the ones I like the least, but these photos are so beautiful. I could give them crazy jumpsuits.
I've been waiting for you.
Okay, I just had to let Elvis finish that song. Oops. Just a sec, I thought I did. Right. Okay, so I've got those two books done. But I really wanted to read out some of the text when I was going through them, but as it turns out, I haven't done that for various reasons. I've been busy today. When I've read them completely, I'll mark some of the text and I'll read it back another time. But just to finish off this video, I want to just talk briefly about a couple of other books. I've got this book, Elvis, The Fact Versus the Fiction. And for those people who didn't like the movie and found there were so many mistakes in it, this book explains everything. It's Trina Young is one of the few journalists who writes books about Elvis, and she's only written a few, but I really like her book. She states the facts. She doesn't deviate. She doesn't... what's the word for it? She doesn't sensationalise anything. She's a fan. She openly admits she's a fan. And you can tell by the way she writes. And the whole book is a scene-by-scene analysis. She goes through the whole movie and examines each scene and goes through where, well, for instance, Elvis leaves the army and focuses on movie roles. The truth score, 9.5 out of 10. As depicted in the scene, Elvis talking about his ambition to be a serious actor. The timing jumps 8 years from Presley's movie role in Flaming Star to his role in Live a Little Lovely. Storyline, 10 out of 10. And it just goes through everything bit by bit and explains. It's so hard to explain, but if you can get this book, I thoroughly recommend it. This is another one I've had for a while. Have I finished? I think I've read it right through. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I have because I couldn't put it down. And Dr. Nick and Colonel Parker, to me, are the two most demonised men out of Elvis's history. This book took him a long time to write, and it's very hard to get hold of, but it's worth every cent. This poor guy really loved Elvis as a friend and his doctor, and he did his best for him. He goes into how they were trying to figure out what was wrong with Elvis, and in those days they didn't have the equipment and the science that we've got now. And he says, looking back, you know, when he wrote this book, looking back at what he knew about Elvis then, what he knows now, he said, we could have saved him, we could have saved his life. That's just such a tragedy that it was just a matter of timing, you know. But beautiful, beautiful, wonderful book. And finally, I got this yesterday or the day before, Elvis and the Colonel. This is the newest book about Elvis and the Colonel. And, I'm thoroughly enjoying it. I haven't read Alana Nash's book about the Colonel. But from what I can gather, there's a fair few untruths in it. Typical of her, sensationalise everything. But this was written by a young teenager, when he met the Colonel and he met Elvis through quite a funny coincidence, and came to live with the Colonel because his father wasn't schooling him properly, so the Colonel and Marie took pity on him and they took him into their home and sent him to school and looked after him and ended up working with the Colonel, sort of meeting Elvis, of course, getting to know him. And it's the book, it's got more truth in it than just about almost any other book I've read, apart from Dr. Nick's book. It is a brilliant background book to Elvis, what happened in the end, and the Colonel's background, and there's so much shit about Elvis. I've always said he's been demonised, and it's worse. The things people say about him are a lot worse than... Well, anyway, so I'm falling over my words again, as I do when I get excited. But again, if you get this book, thoroughly recommend it. You'll learn a lot about Elvis as well as a Colonel. On that note, I'll end it. And my friends are probably due any minute. So tomorrow or whenever I get time, I'll do the two hardcover books, the flip through of the final two books. And I want to talk some more about the other books. So I'll do a face-to-face video. Face-to-face? You know, face-to-camera video in time to come. Catch you later. Have a good weekend. Bye.